Hi, I'm Chad with Mastercam. In this video, I'd like to introduce you to some very powerful new functionality within the Port Expert toolpath. Port Expert is an application-targeted toolpath designed primarily for the CNC cylinder head porting industry. However, you're about to see it can also be very useful in other types of deep or complex pockets. Because of its complex shape, the Formula FSAE Upright presents some unique multi-axis challenges. The pockets on each side of the part are a perfect place to use a Port Expert toolpath and a lollipop mill. From the multi-axis gallery, select Port Expert. On the cut pattern page, I'll select my machining surfaces. I've created a set of surfaces on a separate level for the purposes of this demonstration. I'll window select these surfaces and then choose End Selection. Before modifying any additional settings, it's always a good idea to generate the toolpath and see what the default parameters produce. By getting to see what parts of the toolpath work well and what areas I need to adjust, I'm able to make informed decisions about the parameters I'm changing. Once the toolpath is generated, I'll launch Backplot. The first thing I see is that the cutter is cutting the pocket from both ends. This won't work since the backside of the pocket is not accessible without collisions. Back on the cut pattern page, I'll change the area output type to top and set the toolpath to machine to the maximum depth from the top. This will set the toolpath to cut as deep as possible from the top side without creating any collisions with the machining surfaces. Once the toolpath is regenerated, I'll review it and verify. At first glance, the resulting toolpath is a very nice finishing operation. Upon closer inspection, I can see that the tool is over-engaged in some areas of the cut. Back in Mastercam, I can turn on the stock model that was created after the initial roughing of this pocket. By right-clicking on my section plane and choosing Edit, I can slide the section view along the part and see the remaining stock at each depth. Since the tool that was used to rough this pocket was too large to get into the corners, there's additional stock in the corners that should be removed before finishing. Port Expert has the perfect options to take care of this extra roughing. On the cut pattern page, I'll change pattern from finishing around to roughing. Instead of using the default offset-based Port Expert roughing, I'll choose dynamic. Since I'm roughing with this operation, I'll leave 20/1000ths for finishing. Since this is a dynamic roughing operation, I'm going to set the toolpath up like a regular dynamic operation by decreasing my step over and increasing my step down. I'll also activate rest roughing by toggling the stock checkbox on the stock tab and selecting my stock model. When rest machining with the stock model, it's good to remember that the stock model tolerance directly affects how long the toolpath takes to regenerate. Since this is a roughing operation, there's simply no need for a tight tolerance. All it's going to do is make the toolpath take longer to generate. This is very important to keep in mind, especially when working with large part files. Keep your tolerances set to a value that matches the operation. With a looser tolerance set for the stock model, I can regenerate the toolpath and review it and verify. The dynamic motion looks great. The cutter isn't over-engaged, and the chatter commonly associated with lollipop mills will be minimized. I do see that there are still a few collisions to fix. On the collision control page, I'll toggle the Check Surfaces checkbox and Add Surfaces. I can right-click on the level that contained my surfaces in the Levels Manager and choose Select All Entities. I can also tighten up the tool clearance windows to 10/1000ths each, so I get the deepest possible reach with my tool. On the tool axis control page, I'll set a machine angle range as well. Setting this angle limit will ensure that the toolpath will run within the limitations of my machine. This will help avoid getting an error while posting, an error at the control, or even possibly a collision between machine components. Once the toolpath has regenerated, I'll take a final look at it in machine simulation. The motion is smooth, there's plenty of clearance between machine components, and the operation runs within the machine travel limits as expected. This Port Expert dynamic rest roughing operation was easy to create. It resulted in safe and efficient machine motion, as well as nice consistent cutter engagement. A toolpath of this complexity would be extremely difficult or even impossible to create with any other method. Hopefully you can see how the new features in Port Expert give you, the Mastercam user, more power than ever before.